Alright, so Billy, he walked out to go get a drink, but you know what? I think I can confide in this and you guys. I'm thinking about going solo. I don't need him dragging me down, you know, like I'm a funny guy, right? I'm a funny guy, I think. All right, so we're gonna get back to playing. We're gonna get back to playing the game. Oh,
hey, what's up? Hey, what's happening?
What are you doing?
Huh?
What are you doing?
Did you get those Pringles that I sent you out to get?
God, man. So whenever I see Pringles, that's all I ever think of. God, man.
Oh my God. So I totally wasn't talking about going solo. Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
We're going back into the game. We're going back into the game now. It's been a long time since I've had a Code Red.
Oh,
I remember Code Red was like my jam back in the day, but I don't know. I've come to appreciate Mountain Dew Classic.
Come to appreciate the classics.
I've come to appreciate the finer things in life, like Mountain Dew. That's easily accessible to everyone.
Yeah.
Except homeless people. Those are the only people that can't get it because they don't have any.
That's why you go to McDonald's. You buy a dollar drink, and then you just get nothing but Coke.
I was gonna say they don't have Mountain Dew.
And then you go over to Taco Bell, and you start dumping it up everywhere, and you start filling it up with Mountain Dew.
How weird is it that this great clock at the center of the universe has my face on it?
Yeah, I know.
And I was created after the great clock.
Yeah.
Was made. Presumably.
Or were you?
Well, I mean, we see the birth of Clank in the first...
It's Jimmy. No, it's Tobin.
Okay. What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
I'm going to answer this. Hello. Your father went to great lengths to protect this room. I is be working... working. I is be... hanging out with Taylor, chin strapping chaps. He loved you very much, you know. He was always XJ0461 this and XJ0461 that. I'm supposed to play this for you. Oh. Toby wants to know if he wants to hang.
Maybe when we're playing Half-Life 2.
So, yeah.
In a little bit.
Yeah, in a little bit, though. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Give him a call later.
Yeah, he says he'll be home in about an hour.
Oh, that works then. That's okay. Good. That's
yeah,
good.
That'll be good. Alright, bye-bye.
Yeah, because we gotta get the spooky scary.
Or cut that all out.
We gotta get all the porn.
Yep.
Well, we've already got the porn check.
I feel like if we had a checklist of things to do in the episode... That would be just the one thing.
Porn.
It just says porn, big bold font with a big checkbox, and then just, okay, got that done. You want some?
No, thank you.
They stink. They stink so good. But yeah, we gotta get...
So do they actually have that game?
What?
Fighting game?
Oh, no. They have one... Actually, it's a co-op game, I think you and I could play it if you wanted. They have a game at the Agorian Battleplex called My Blaster Runs Hot.
That sounds sexy.
It's basically like Smash TV.
Oh, okay.
It's a two-stick shooter where you play as you play as Quark, and then I think you can get... I think the second player is Rusty Pete, I think. I don't know. I don't remember. But yeah, it's essentially Smash TV. And you rescue civilians and defeat evil. Not looking like that, though. That's the perfect reaction, I think.
Yeah. I was gonna say something. What was I gonna say?
Sweet, we're back to playing as Ratchet. I don't have to play as Clank no more.
There is one last thing of porn that I forgot to say.
Okay.
Because there's Shad Basin. Shad.
Can I skip this? Thank you. Thank God. Thank you. Shed Basin, yeah.
Shed Basin, Shed something else, I can't think of right now. Corner. Anyway, it's the thing that other people can contribute to.
Oh.
And it's the newest one was Trappy New Rear.
Trappy New Rear.
So it's this girl that has a penis.
Okay.
And it's focused on her, her butt.
Okay.
And then I'm like, oh, sweet girl. Oh.
Well, it can never be just girl.
No. Well, you see.
How the fuck did I land?
Every time, it's always the same person who draws all the traps constantly. And that's,
Oh, traps as in.
Like, women with penises.
Yeah, it appears to be a woman, but then there's dick involved.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't really quite get the whole trap part.
Yeah, Trappy New Year.
I thought you meant trap like the music genre.
No.
I don't even know what that is.
I'm trying to think, what's his fucking name? He was on...
You
sons
of bitches, I will murder you and your family.
Well, I mean, this is their family, so you have done it.
Alright, that is done now.
Oh, God. What is...
This moon is stupid, because I gotta fucking go around these damn things.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Way to miss.
How did I make it the first time? Like, I couldn't even see where I landed.
Yeah, but you did it.
I did it.
He was on fucking Steam... Or not Steam, Train. Fucking... He was on... Table Flip.
Jeez. Oh, my God. I don't watch Table Flip, so I don't know. Table Flip's a good idea in concept, but it's boring to watch, if you ask me.
It depends on the game. Some games I like, but most of the time I don't watch
it. I've seen enough. I mean, like, I remember they played that House on Haunted Hill game, and it's like, that's kind of cool to watch, because, I mean, that's a good game.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, I don't know. But I mean, like, I don't know. Even so, like, I still kind of felt like, I don't know. There's something about it that I don't really care about. I'm not a big board game guy anyway, so...
Yeah.
I'm one to talk. Oh.
I love board games.
You fucking piece of shit. I love cheese. Sometimes I dream of cheese.
Sometimes I dream of cheese.
Is that from something, or did you just make that up?
Gmod.
Oh.
If you... It's like... You can make your person say things. It's a set loop of stuff.
Uh-huh.
And it's in the funny. Oh. It's like, oh, I'm so hungry I could eat a horse. And then it's just randomly,
sometimes I dream
of cheese. It's just weird. I always picture I'm the black guy when I'm doing it too.
I think, well, you brought it up in the Half-Life one. In the Half-Life 2 episode, and I didn't know that's what it was from, but it was that one girl that you find in that pipe.
And she's like, hey, over here! Oh, the resistance is gonna help you out!
It's just, psst, over here!
But I gotta turn to my cat!
Psst, over here! Oh, these are the best lasers in the game.
Oh, the bzzz.
Yeah. Yes, the bzzz. Yeah, these they're totally like Star Trek lasers, man. Why do I even?
It reminds me of. I think it was like Gradius or.
All right, you know what? I'm gonna say screw getting any of the zonies because they just upgrade my ship, and my ship's really not that important.
So. Yeah,
I'm gonna
do
it. If there is a weapon mod, I will get that. But other than that, I'm not gonna do the zony ones. All right, so I'll do Bernelius Cumberbatch Towel over here. I'm sorry, what were you saying? I interrupted you. Sorry.
What was I saying?
About Star Trek lasers?
Psst, over here. Sometimes I dream of cheese.
I didn't even stop and listen to her because I don't care. Really just gave a thumbs up. That's really, I mean, I want to see... A Half-Life movie, and then that's all that... Yeah, that's all Gordon Freeman does. He just thumbs up everything.
It's like, Gordon, you gotta go into Ravenloft. He's just...
He thumbs down.
It's like, no, no, man.
I can imagine him being like, you know, like a Roman royalty, like during like the you know, the gladiator fights.
Arena. And he's arena just, is just,
he always thumbs up.
Shall he live or shall he die? It always goes from the side and it's just, and everyone's like,
God damn it.
Let him die. No one ever dies in this gladiator arena.
I guess he's got some morals, huh?
Yeah.
He's completely a blank slate, other than the fact that he has morals.
He won't let people die.
He won't let people die. And then later on, like he jumps down. He thumbs up, but then he jumps down from the thing and just beats him to death with a crowbar.
It's the worst death. It could have been just a nice, clean slice.
Well, nothing was clean back then.
Okay. A nice... one slice that would just kill you pretty outright, but now you gotta get beat to
death. Get like a rusty dull blade and just like keep hacking.
Have you ever seen? I can't. I know I'm gonna get the name of this video wrong, but it's
two more. Where are they at?
It's overly long death with a. Something inch weapon.
I might have seen that. That sounds kind of familiar, actually.
It's a guy following another guy with a spoon.
Yeah.
And just hitting him.
I've seen that.
I've seen that. That video is hilarious. Because that's exactly something I would do.
Yeah. I don't exactly remember what happens in it. I have seen it, though.
That guy shoots the guy.
I don't need no toxic. I like shrapnel.
Yeah, shrapnel. The guy shoots the guy, stabs the guy, but he just keeps coming back with the spoon and keeps...
Yeah. I'm pretty sure you could murder somebody with a spoon.
Oh, yeah. But the way he's hitting, I don't know.
I remember they made a joke about that on All That. Somebody said, like, don't run with a spoon, you could hurt yourself, but nobody, you know, all kids are raised to say, don't run with scissors or something like that, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
But then, like, he runs, and then you see him, like, run through, like, a door, and then you hear, like, a poof, and then he comes back, and then the fucking spoon's just lodged in his head. And he's just like, yeah, you weren't kidding! Don't run with a spoon! Or something like that.
I mean, really, that's completely true.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure if you
don't run with any objects
that could impale you.
Because, well, don't run with any object
except a football.
Because almost anything can impale you.
Except a football.
Yeah, except for a football.
Unless it's a Tron football, then it might.
Captain, he's just being a dick! He keeps following behind me!
I will admit, there is one other power-up that I would like to get for the ship, but I'm not going to waste the time doing it, because it's just like, I don't know. It's the... There's, like, the extra missiles that you get. Are really cool,
yeah.
Because it's like... It's like a swarm thing, so it's like, you shoot out, like, two rockets, and then they explode into, like, 20 rockets. And then it murders everything. Excuse me, God. I mean, it's a cool thing. I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. Give me a status update. How about no, you stupid Dutch bastard?
No, it's been weakened.
I got a new controller. It's plated in pure gold.
Cost $20.
$54. I think it was worth it. I mean, I still play PS3 games quite a bit. So I mean, I think it was a good purchase. The one thing I will admit that I really like about this part of the game is just look at the space. Just look at it. Like, look, I was, like, flying into, like, this fucking nebula over here. Look at this shit.
It's so colorful.
It's so cool looking.
This one's very blue.
Yeah, look at that. That's crazy. I mean, like, sure, I'm sure other games have better looking space, but I mean, like, this still looks really cool.
That game that we were gonna make, it would look better.
Oh, the game that we hypothetically made up and said we were gonna make, but nobody would have the budget to do it.
Yeah.
You know what I find odd?
They actually have stuff like that, pretty close to what we were thinking.
You know what I find odd? And this is kind of like a real topic. This is not a... There's no joke.
Yeah.
No joke here. So we don't joke around on Chinstrap Chaps. We're all real all the time.
All real.
All real housewives of Chinstrap Chaps. Is Destiny. You know, it's a pretty big sci-fi game. Looked pretty cool when it was first being conceived and shit. You know, pretty cool. You know how much... How big of a budget that game had?
$12.
Take a wild serious guess.
Serious guess?
Serious guess.
Probably like 100. $15 million, $20 million.
You're not even close. You're not even close.
Too high, too low?
Way too low.
Okay, then what I was thinking originally, maybe like $150 million?
No, you're still off by a lot. Apparently, from my understanding, I could be wrong, I haven't actually looked this up, but I think from what I've heard, the game had a $500 million budget. And I want to know where they spent all that money, because doesn't really need to have that much. There's nothing in the game to justify it being that big of a budget. I could be wrong. I really could be talking on my ass right now. But, like,
because that's a movie.
Well, you know, Gravity? That only had a $100 million budget. And they had, like, wild and crazy, like, you know, lifty sort of, like, cable things going on and shit to, like, lift Sandra Bullock to make it seem like she was in outer space. And they had, like, a completely, like, you know, CG rigged thing for, like, you know, shooting all the scenes with her and George Clooney. Like, there was, like, one set the entire movie. Because the whole thing takes place in space.
Yeah.
It was only $100 million, and apparently somehow Destiny managed to get 5 times as much money for that. And yet they spent it all on hookers and blow. Apparently. They spent it on the after party and nothing else. Like, they spent, like, maybe $50,000 on the game, and then the rest of it went to just getting as much...
Hookers and blow.
As much hookers and blow as possible. Because seriously, like, there's no reason for that game to have that much of a budget with, like, so little content. I don't know. Sorry, I had to get real for you. Next time on Chinstrap Chaps, we go back to talking about whatever we were talking about. Star Trek, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll talk about Star Trek.
It's got beams and stuff.
I don't know. Yeah, it's got beams like... Pew! Pew!